हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। प्रेस द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू हैव टू टैप द बेल आइकन एडजेसेंट टू द सब्सक्राइब बटन लाइक दिस एंड देन यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन फ्रॉम माय चैनल।
हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई वुड बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू रैंकाइन हाफ बॉडी। नाउ इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल बाय प्रेसिंग द रेड सब्सक्राइब बटन बिलो। Do follow me on Google Plus, Twitter, Facebook. All the links are given in the description. Do watch my other videos. All the links are given in the description below. If you have any doubt regarding this video or suggestion or feedback, please mention in the comment section. Do press the like button if you like this video and do share on social media such as WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, etc. Now, Rankine half body. Rankine half body is formed when there is uniform flow plus the source flow. So, uniform flow and the source flow combination, it forms the Rankine half body. Now this is the Rankine half body, that is the dashed, that is B C S C dash B dash. This is the Rankine half body. Now this is the uniform flow. These are the streamlines for the uniform flow and this is the source flow. Now the characteristics of Rankine half body is that here is a stagnation point at which the combined resultant velocity is zero, stagnation point S, and the flow starting from the source, from this source here, so it cannot penetrate beyond this point. It cannot penetrate, and these are the equipotential line, phi lines and xi lines are always orthogonal or perpendicular. Now free stream velocity is u naught, and I will prove that this is the distance m upon 2 u naught and this distance is m upon 2 pi u naught. Now m is the strength of the source, so xi is equal to xi uniform plus xi source, because xi for Rankine half body is, because Rankine half body is formed from combination of uniform flow plus source flow, so the streamline will also be the combination of uniform flow plus source flow. So xi is equal to u naught y plus m theta by 2 pi, or y is equal to r sine theta. So xi is equal to u naught r sine theta plus m theta by 2 pi. Equation number 1. Similarly, phi, equipotential lines, is equal to phi uniform plus phi source, is equal to u naught x plus m by 2 pi log to the base e r. Phi is equal to u naught r cos theta plus m by 2 pi ln r. Equation number 2. Now at point S, that is at point S, stagnation point, the resultant velocity is 0. So velocity, free stream velocity is u naught, and m upon 2 pi r. This is the velocity for the source flow. So resultant will be, the addition will be 0, and here it is minus m upon 2 pi r, because the free stream flows in this direction and the source flow, it originates from this to this direction from here, so the resultant will be, it will be a negative. So as to compensate for the sign, I have substituted negative here. So resultant will be u naught plus minus m upon 2 pi r is equal to 0, or we get the r is equal to m upon 2 pi u naught. R means this distance, the distance from the source of the stagnation point is m upon 2 pi u naught, and then it can be said that at a stagnation point S, it lies at a distance m upon 2 pi u naught, where the net velocity is 0, stagnation point. Alright, now when r is equal to rs, that is the radial distance at a stagnation point, so theta will be equal to pi, because stagnation point occurs at that point, so theta will be 180 degree or pi. So substituting in phi equation, phi is equal to u naught r sine theta plus m theta by 2 pi, so theta is equal to pi, and here pi also, and here pi also. So sin pi is 0 and pi gets cancelled, so xi is equal to m by 2. So this is the streamline which acts as the Rankine half body. So So this is the main equation for Rankine half body, that xi is equal to m by 2. And then generalized equation we can get by substituting this xi in the original xi equation, that is xi is equal to m by 2 is equal to u naught y plus m theta by 2 pi. Xi is equal to m by 2 for this is equal to u naught y plus m theta by 2 pi, because xi was equal to this and xi was equal to this, so we equate these two. So calculate y. So y is equal to m by 2 u naught pi into pi minus theta. Now for different theta we can get value of different y, that is at theta is equal to 0, y is equal to theta you put 0, y is equal to m upon 2 u naught, because pi pi gets cancelled, and theta is equal to pi by 2, you substitute here pi by 2, y is equal to m upon 4 u naught. Similarly at theta equal to 3 pi by 2, y is equal to minus m upon 4 u naught, theta is equal to 2 pi, y is equal to minus m upon 2 u naught. And the radial velocity vr is equal to 1 upon r del xi upon del theta. So you differentiate xi, that is u naught r sine theta plus m theta by 2 pi, you differentiate with respect to theta and divide by r, we get u naught cos theta plus m upon 2 pi r. And v theta is equal to minus del xi upon del r, we get minus u naught sine theta. So the resultant velocity v will be under root vr square plus v theta square. And experimentally it is calculated that v max is equal to 1.25 u naught, and it occurs that theta is equal to 117 degree. And there is one term which is known as coefficient of pressure, Cp. It is denoted by P minus P naught upon half rho u naught square, where P is the pressure at any general point in the flow field and P naught is the pressure in the free stream, and u naught is the free stream velocity, rho is the density of the flowing fluid, that is particularly air or liquid or water. So from Bernoulli's equation we get P minus P naught is equal to rho by 2 into u naught square minus v square. So rho by 2 gets cancelled and u naught square divide by this, so we get finally Cp is equal to 1 minus v square upon u naught square, where v is the resultant velocity and u naught is the free stream velocity. So this is the coefficient of pressure, and this coefficient is coefficient of pressure, it is used to study the lift and drag. The plot is drawn on the y axis and x axis between coefficient of pressure and theta. If it occurs, if the graph is symmetrical about y axis, then there is no drag, and if it is symmetrical about x axis, if it is about y axis means graph is like this, so equal portion on left and right on of pi axis, so no drag force. And if Cp is plotted, if the plot between Cp and theta, it is symmetrical about x axis like this, it is symmetrical about x axis like this, so there will be no drag. And similarly, if there is unequal distribution between the axes, then we can say that lift occurs or drag occurs. So this was the video regarding Rankine half body, and I hope so this was the requested video from one of my subscriber, and I hope that all are benefited from this video, because Rankine half body is important topic in the fluid kinematics. And so if you have found this video helpful, please press the like button. Do comment if you have any doubt regarding this video or any suggestion or feedback. Please subscribe my channel by pressing the red subscribe button below. Share this video. Till next time, take care. Bye bye.